What is the most important in intensity in yoga? I am teaching you now. The only two things. One is called agility. Agility. Another one is called resilience. Resilience. These are two very important words. Agility means how quick you are. Are you like a Bruce Lee? Your movement. Is your movement is like a, whether you can see that quickness in your body. Reflex. Quick reflex. The quick reflex happens only when you see elephant, when you see tiger, when you see a snake, when you see someone whom you don't like, the reflex comes. That is involuntary. But can you do the same reflex with volunteer? When I am moving, when I am doing asana like this, I am just going like this. Can you cope with it? And I am going like this. You can observe it in a state. Presses like this, and jumping like this, and going like this, climbing down like this, jumping like this, like going like this, and going up like this, and jumping like this. How quickly I am moving? Can you cope with it? You can't. By the time I finish 3 rounds, still your legs are behind. You're struggling to go. Why? You must have gone to gym. You must have gone to marathon. It shows inertia. How much inertia you have. How less acceleration you have. Quick reflex. Quick to response. Quick to response. How quick you respond. Not react. Reaction is fight and flight mechanism. Here is a quick response. It is not quick reaction. What the other way you generate is, you know what is a quick reaction because it is not in your control. But what is? What is agility? And every exercise it has to teach you the quality of quick to respond. A Bruce Lee, very quick to respond. And that's why no boxer in front of him can stay. Speed. Quick, and the speed kills. Even a blade, even ordinary grass, when you use a speed, when it is added a speed, it can cut your throat. Ordinary blade, ordinary grass, kusa grass, speed. Speed, quick response. It can cut, so it makes your body so light when you do this. Agility is experiencing that lightness in the body. You know, and then resilience. What is resilience? How quick to adapt. Are quick to accept. Are quick to change. Are quick to live in the present. How quick you are to live in the present. 'Hey, teach me Kumar some practice. Every day I watch that. I will do that like a robot. Your resilience is gone. There is no resilience. Resilience means every day I am doing and along with me you are doing. It is not that you record, you first watch, then afterwards the evening and while I am doing and then you remember and you do on your own. Means your resilience is zero. What I am teaching all my students, yoga students, you ask them. I must have trained thousands of yoga teachers. Not, I don't want to be called them as teachers. It is, thousands of students did a systematic yoga course for 3 months, 6 months and they all transformed their lives. Those who really wanted, their lives have transformed completely. I can 100% tell you. How? So what I taught them, always they have to, I never tell them what I am going to teach them, number one. The way to develop the resilience, you should never know what your teacher is going to talk, which theory. Number one. Number two, what practice he is going to give. The next moment, what is next moment? In the next moment, and next, your movement should never be known. What am I training you to live in this moment? Your movement has to be as per this moment, in this moment. That's called resilience. And that's why in the beginning people find difficult. And automatically it makes you surrender, it makes you observer. What is observer? Listener. The training is all to be observer, drashta, and to become, to observe all the time, to be mindful all the time. Observe, listen. Every word what Guru is explaining, you are observing him, you are listening him. Then only you can do it. Now many of you, because you are pampered, and for you, while I am doing to cope with my, all my students can do, it takes first 10 days, 15 days they struggle. But after 15 days you should see everyone falls into line. And at the end of the 3 months, you should see all of them, and how quickly I respond, they also respond that quickly. What I taught them? Resilience. Do you think the next moment, what is going to happen in the world will come and tell you? The next moment, God is going to tell you this is going to happen? Do you think he will tell next moment accident is going to happen to your car? Do you think life is, you know, coming with a warranty next moment with you? Are you sure? All our unhappiness is we are not prepared for the next moment. You are expecting next moment to be in your way. But it doesn't happen. The next moment is the way the world functions. What you deserve, the next moment, not as per your wish. Because electron, proton, everything in this moment is a logic. It is a part of the logic. It cannot work as per your logic. If you want, and your logic is inferior compared to that logic, you are making a bad choice. That's why they say choiceless. Whatever the moment it is, accept it. Because that's the way you grow. That's the way you adapt. And that's the way you shine. That's the way you are happy. That's the way you are strong. Like any species outside. Yoga is all about species. Every species is adapting. You say crow posture. You say monkey posture. You say peacock posture. You say swan posture. What are these? They have adapted. Swan is adapted. A owl in Arctic. A Arctic is like minus 35, minus 45, minus 70 degrees. And people thought there is no bird. But they found there is so much of night life over there. So much of life over there. So why? Adaptive resilience. That's what a human is supposed to develop. Now, a corona, afraid. Next moment, you are not prepared. It is all about how you prepare yourself. How much prepared you are for the next moment. And without knowing, a soldier doesn't know what's going to happen in the war field. He has to be prepared. Unfortunately, these soldiers and their preparedness is all about going into BP, blood pressure raising, tension raising, and they go into, you know, testosterone boosting. They forget themselves in the josh, in that, you know, in that gone out of state, they fight. That's why they get killed. They lose that moment of balance of the mind. So yoga is all about resilience.